This is how to download, install, configure, and run VirtualBox, as well as Fedora 35 inside of VirtualBox. Open our web browser, type in VirtualBox, go to the first link. Over here on the left, we're going to click on Downloads. Here are your downloads right here. If you're on a Windows machine like me, we're going to click Windows Host. If you're on Mac or Linux, you'll click the corresponding one. We're going to click Save. And this is going to download. It'll take us a couple seconds. Once this is finished downloading, we're going to open it up, click Run. It's going to open the wizard. We're going to click Next. Next. Here it'll ask you if you want a shortcut on the desktop or a shortcut on the quick launch bar. I'm just going to keep all these checked and click Next. Warning network interfaces, just click Yes on this. We're just installing virtual network interfaces. Click Install. I'm going to click Yes. And now we're going to click Finish and it should open VirtualBox up. Close out of this. Oh, here it is. And we have our shortcut on our desktop over here. So to create a virtual machine, we're going to click New. And give it a name. We're going to call it Test. Pick what type of virtual machine we want. I'm going to go Linux and I'm going to pick Fedora 64-bit. Click Next. Here you can allocate part of your RAM to the virtual machine. I'm going to leave this as the default because we can change it later. I'm going to create a virtual hard disk. You want to do that more than likely. Hard disk file type. We're going to stick with the default VirtualBox's format. Storage on a physical hard disk. We're going to go to a fixed size. We're not going to allocate more storage as we need it. We're just going to give it a fixed amount. And here we're going to pick how big we want that storage to be. I'm going to say 16 gigabytes. Click Create. This also, you can also configure here where you want your virtual hard disk to be stored. All right, once that is done, we can see we have our virtual machine here. It's named Test. Now before we start this, because I'm using Fedora, we're going to go to getfedora.org. I'm going to click on Fedora Workstation, download now. And we're looking for the ISO file. So we're going to download Fedora 35x86-64 DVD ISO. Click Save. And it's going to take a second to download. Alright, now that this is downloaded, we're going to go back to our VirtualBox. Make sure we click on our virtual machine. Open up settings. Go to system. I'm just going to crank up my memory a little bit here. Give it 4 gigs. Give some more processing power. Go over to display. Crank up my video memory a little bit, just so my virtual machine runs a little smoother. We're going to click on Storage, and under Controller IDE, we're going to click on this little disk over on the right here. We're going to click Choose a Disk File, and here we have our ISO file we downloaded. We're going to open that. You can see it's selected, and we're going to click OK. Now we can click Start to boot up our virtual machine. We shouldn't run into any issues here. See, it's booting up. It says Fedora Workstation Live 35, so we're going to use the arrow keys, the enter key to navigate, to click Start. Alright, so our Fedora finished opening up. We can expand this window, give us some more space to work in. So I'm going to click Install to Hard Drive. Now we're just going to go through the basic setup process. We're going to click our language. See, I'm gonna pick English here. Click Continue. Select our language, our time and date. Our install destination. Here we have our virtual disk we created earlier. Select that. Click Done. You can see that selected. We're gonna click Begin Installation. All right. Now that this is finished installing, we're gonna click Finish Installing. We're going to power off our virtual machine. before we restart it, we should go into settings, storage, click on our disk, and remove disk from virtual drive. Click OK, click start. That ISO file or virtual disk serves essentially the same purpose as a boot disk or boot USB for Windows or any operating system. So we have to remove that if we want our virtual machine to boot properly. We can start our setup and go through all these steps. Link our Google account. That is how to download and install Fedora 35 through Oracle VirtualBox, as well as how to configure VirtualBox.